Boulevard with my sister in 1951. And we were actually baptized together in the same baptistry and whatever. And immediately after, I was only like 12, and they made me a Sunday school secretary, and I had to play the piano for every other worship service. So I had planned the worship service every other week at the age of 12. Then we moved, and my parents weren't going to anything. I moved out here to California in 54, and 54, and I started going to the Baptist church. My parents weren't going anywhere, so I kept that. And I also, one of the teachers was doing a Bible study, so I went Bible study with them. Graduated when I was 17, and was immediately admitted into a nursing school down here in Hollywood Presbyterian on Sunset Boulevard. And immediately after my first year, my parents were going to a Christian church in Corona, and so the people in charge of that particular area asked me to be the school nurse for Soap Opera Seco up on Angeles Crest. Well, I was only 18 at the time. I had gone through 1 year of nurses training. And as I walked out of the nurses thing, here was all the boys that were there. It was a high school camp. They were all 18 and nursing, just me. And they thought that was really funny because I was the only nurse that went with them on all their hikes. I made myself a little first aid kit and went along with all of them. And at night, the end of the week, we have an amphitheater up on the hillside, and we had a big bonfire and a gathering. And at that time, I got this thing. I had always thought my mother, in the back of my mind, said, you guys are old enough, you need to go forward. So I was never sure that I accepted the Lord on my own, or if it was because my mother told me to go down. So I went down that night at Soap Opera Seco and rededicated my life to the Lord and went back. And I was in charge of the chapel service at the nursing school, and it was piped out to the hospital every Thursday night. I was in charge of that while I was there on the campus. And then it just sort of, marriage got in the way, kids got in the way, and then I almost died after my son was born. He was born on Halloween, and I didn't get out of the hospital until President Kennedy was assassinated. I'll always remember that, because I saw the assassination as waiting to go home. November 22nd of 1963.
What day?
November 22nd. It was at 12 noon, actually, in 1963. And then, it's just the Lord has done crazy things in my life. I'm getting nervous now. Besides that episode in 63, then I had another episode in 74, and the doctor put me on bed rest for a month. 2 weeks later, I started CSUN, and it took me 45 minutes to walk from the Fine Arts building up to the engineering building where my classes were. I just had to snail it. And they let me sit in the office between classes to rest. And so then I got over that with the Lord's help. And then when I was in, we took the chorus I was singing with, took a performing tour in the middle of Italy, and we were in Assisi going through the Franciscan Priory, the upper floor. And all of a sudden it hit me again that I needed to get back into church, back with people. And study the Bible more. And so I joined up here, and thank goodness for Larry Buser, because he was doing work at my house, and he showed up at my door with tickets to your Christmas concert down by Master's College. And so I went to that, and that got me thinking more and more about it. So then I joined the church with Robin's mother and father. The same day we were sitting at the same table, Peter was at our table, and that's when I started at Grace Baptist. And what was neat about it, I immediately got into Women of Grace, immediately got into small groups, because I knew I was isolated because I live on 5 acres all by myself in the middle of nowhere. And so I knew I needed to talk to people. And I'm having trouble talking because I don't talk all week. And shoot. Anyway, I then decided to join the choir. And I was still singing with the other chorus as well. And it just happened that I did not have one conflicting day. I would sing with that chorus on Wednesday and come here on Thursday night. And I even performed in the conference center when we did the patriotic. Patriotic music and all dressed in red, white, and blue. And then I started taking Pastor Hicks theology class. So I had Women of Grace on Tuesday night. I got here at 5:30 Wednesday morning to take his theology class. Went home, came back at 9 o'clock for Joy Bible Study. Went home, came back at 5:30 for precept, co-ed class, and then choir on Thursday night. And so I was back and forth here all the time. And it was just so great because I'm still taking lots of classes. I take classes on a 2-hour class on Monday morning and another hour class on Thursday, and choir. And I have the prayer group with Janet every Tuesday morning at 6:30 in the morning. And that's been going for years. I don't remember how long it was. But my husband died, and I realized I was holding a lot of bitterness in my heart. And so I literally threw myself on the living room floor and prayed to God and cried that he'd take away the bitterness from me. And I was out walking outside, and all of a sudden I bent over and went like that. And when I stood up, I went, what was that? I didn't have any more bitterness in me. It was all gone. It was totally gone. And then in 95, I had to retire early from work because I got allergic to all the chemicals used in the building. And I was having trouble getting the county office to retire me, even though I was 55 at the time. And the lady from Stirs in Sacramento gave me a phone call. She says, I was reading your application for retirement. I was just going to throw it out. She says, but you qualify for disability. You need to get a doctor's note in here. And so I sent the doctor's note, and they immediately put me on disability because I couldn't possibly have lived on my retirement. And that pushed it up a little bit so that I was able to live, not comfortably, but, you know, eking out pennies all the time. And I just got to say, then I had knee surgery. I've had 2 stents put in. I've had gone to the hospital with a bloody nose that I couldn't get stopped. I've had my aortic valve replaced. And in every single situation, I was not nervous at all. I was the calmest person in that entire floor because I knew I was in God's hands and I didn't have to worry about it. That's mainly it, to
order. Yeah. I love it. Thank you, Cheryl. Thank you.
But you stayed
even
though he was
angry. Yes, yeah, she stayed. In spite of me. Must have been my wife. Definitely. Wow. You must be the smartest person in the world with all those classes you're missing. That's great.